In this video, we are going to take a look at the insert assembly constraint in Autodesk Inventor. I have here an assembly and I'm going to fasten the bolt and the nuts to the assembly, but I'm actually going to do this twice. I'm first going to do it using nothing but mate and flush constraints, and then I will do it using insert constraints so that you can really see the benefit of using the insert constraint. First, I'm going to start by putting this bolt into the hole. I will constrain the axis of this bolt to the axis of the hole here. I can go ahead and apply that and cancel it. As you can see, it's free to go in and out. So I'm going to need another constraint here between the plane here, and I need to switch it to mate if it's not already. And then I'll mate those two together and then I can apply. Of course, I can come back in with an angular constraint as well, but in the interest of time, I will just move on without the angular constraint. Next, I will constrain the nuts to the bolt. So I'll use my constraint tool, axis and axis, and apply, and then axis and axis and apply. Now they're still free to move in and out, so I'm going to have to come back with some mate constraints here. So I'll choose my constrain and mate that surface to the bottom of the nut here. Apply that. And then once again, mate a couple of surfaces together here. Now once again, I can come back in with some angular constraints as well, but I'll leave this for now. Now, the insert constraint is basically going to be two constraints in one. It's going to line up the axes and the faces. So whereas it took me two constraints to put this bolt in, I can now do it with one. So I'll choose the constrain tool and the insert option here. And then I'm going to select two things. And what I want to select are not going to be necessarily faces. They're going to be rings. So this ring right here signifies not only the axis, but also the plane that I want to line up. So as you can see, I can pick up some of these other rings here as well. But if I select this one, that indicates the axis and the plane that I'm dealing with. So when I come to the hole, I want to do the same thing. I want to select this ring because that puts those two planes together and lines their axes up. So I can apply and cancel. And now you can see the only thing left is the angle. So same thing with these nuts. I can constrain, insert. I'll choose the ring on the bottom. And then I'll choose the ring on the top of the part here. And apply. And then one more time, I'll get the ring on the bottom of this nut and the ring on the top of this one and apply that. And as you can see, I was able to do that in half as many constraints. So when you have cylindrical features going into other cylindrical features like holes, the insert is a great way to put those together. That concludes this look at the insert assembly constraint in Autodesk Inventor.